Hello and welcome. Today I will be walking you through how to make use of the expanded settings mod for Space Engineers. This mod allows players to fine-tune their gameplay experience with a single, all-purpose mod without having to rely on dozens of smaller mods that change only a couple of values. Whether you're running a large server or setting up a hardcore solo campaign, you can tweak every setting to suit your needs. To start, we will add the mod to an existing world and load in. Loading in once and then exiting will generate the associated config files and allow us to begin modifying the game. Go into the save folder for the world we just loaded and look for the storage folder. Storage, expanded settings, config.xml. Open it up. The config.xml file contains the majority of the core multipliers. Max speed, weapon damage, detector range, player health, etc. Let's try raising the max speed multipliers. Most values in the config files are set to -1 by default in order to disable them. Setting them to any positive value, or 0, in some cases, will enable them. The block modifiers affect block damage resistance, construction time, and deconstruction time. The sensor modifiers can change the maximum range for all detectors and sensors. Camera zoom is also included here. The power modifiers allow for more control over energy economy and balance. Solar panels, wind turbines, hydrogen engines, reactors, and batteries can all be modified here. The thruster modifiers can be used to change the power or hydrogen cost of using the different thrusters, as well as their maximum thrust. Gyro strength and parachute drag are also included here. The wheel multipliers can be used to alter various costs and limits associated with wheel blocks. Please use these responsibly. The tools modifiers affect the range and speed of player tools. The H2O2 block modifiers allow for control over hydrogen and oxygen balance. Tank capacity, bottle capacity, and ice-to-gas conversion ratios can all be changed here. The comms block modifiers will allow you to change range limits for beacons and antennas. The light block modifiers can be used to change the maximum range of light-emitting blocks. The subgroup block modifiers allow for control over various limits for pistons, rotors, and hinges. Please use these responsibly as well. The space blocks modifiers will change values for blocks related to artificial gravity and jump drives. Things like gravity generator range and jump drive power requirement can be set here. The character modifiers control player character stats. Modifiers for player health, inventory, gas consumption, jetpack strength, and more are available here. The weapon modifiers can adjust both handheld and block weapons. Damage, range, bullet spread, and recoil can be modified here. The visual modifiers allow for control of the interface highlight color and thickness. Next up, we have the config Blueprint XML. This file is used to manipulate the conversion ratio and production time for the various blueprints. All refinement yield as well as the cost for every component or tool can be adjusted individually. This list will include even blueprints from other mods, so modders, components, and tools will all appear in this list if they are loaded when the file is generated. And finally, we have the config Voxel XML file. Here we can change various things about ores in the world. The ore yield modifiers will allow you to change how much ore drops when it is mined. This can even be set to zero to make the ore drop nothing. Next we have the asteroid ore modifiers. These can be used to change the appearance frequency of all the various ores inside of asteroids. They are all set relative to each other, so setting Iced to an iron to 1 will make Iced twice as likely to appear as iron. They can also be set to 0 to prevent the TOR from appearing at all in asteroids. Changing these values can even change the contents of ores that have already been seen or mined in world, so keep that in mind when adjusting an existing world. The final group controls the depth and thickness of ores that appear on planets. Firstly, make sure to set Planet Ore Modifier as active to true if you want to make any changes in this group. The depth multiplier for each ore can be used to make ores appear deeper or shallower underground. The thickness multiplier can be used to increase or decrease how thick the ore veins are. Setting this to 0 will eliminate the TOR from the planet entirely. As with the asteroid modifiers, these changes can be used on existing worlds without any issues. In addition to general ore rebalancing, this config file can be used to effectively limit which ores appear on which planets to shape a specific game flow from planet to planet. All modded planets and ores will also appear in this config file if they are loaded when the file is generated. That covers the basics as they are currently implemented, though more modifiers will be added going forward upon request. This mod supports single player, multiplayer, and dedicated servers. Thank you for watching, and I hope you enjoy playing with all the new settings.